Hey, this is Panda-chan, and I'm outside today, and today I want to talk about Pokemon X and Y. Alright, so Pokemon X and Y just came out on October 12th on Saturday, 2013. So it's been out for less than a week, and I've been enjoying it on my pink 3DS XL. And the legendaries for the games include Xerneas and Yveltal. So Xerneas on X and Yveltal on Y. Pokemon X and Y were two of the most highly anticipated games for 2013. Like mentioned before, the legendaries featured in these games are Xerneas and Yveltal. Of course, a new game means new starters, which are Chespin, Fennekin, and Froakie, along with many other new Pokemon. In addition to new Pokemon, the new fairy type has been added. Also, some previous generation Pokemon, such as Jigglypuff, Meryl, and Ralts, have been re-identified as fairy type, or at least part fairy type. This new type of Pokemon is super effective against Dragon-type Pokemon. In fact, it appears that Dragon-type moves have no effect on Fairy-type Pokemon at all, as that is what happened when I ordered one of my Pokemon to use Dragon Rage on a Flabébé. Fairy-type Pokemon seem to be good against Fighting-type Pokemon as well. One of the features included in Pokemon X and Y are Pokemon and Me, in which you get to pet, feed, talk to, and even play games with your Pokemon. The key is to match your Pokemon's affection, making it perform better in battle, along with keeping its enjoyment and fullness up. One of the games closest to anything like Pokemon and Me is Hey You Pikachu for the N64.
Which I still have.
Anyway, the feel of the appearance of the game's towns and general environments are quite a step up from its previous games, Pokemon Black and White. Up until now, Pokemon games only allowed four-directional movement, but now diagonal movement has been added. The graphics and feel of the battles have been updated too, and are more visually satisfying than Pokemon Black and White. Another difference is that the classic bicycle has been replaced with rollerblades. I think that this is a nice change, though I'm sure some would prefer the bike instead. If you've been playing Pokemon since Generation 1 like I have, then you're fully aware of how much this game is a leap from the original Pokemon games for the Game Boy, such as Pokemon Yellow.
Which I also still have.
So far, I can honestly say that I'm tremendously enjoying Pokemon X. I haven't gotten far enough to try the new Mega Evolution yet, but I'm excited to try it out. The Mega Evolution and new Fairy type will be two elements that'll change the playing field for Pokemon battles, enabling trainers to come up with new strategies. I feel like Game Freak did their homework well with this one. This game makes me look forward to upcoming Pokemon games, whether that'll be Pokemon X and Y Squared, or remakes of Ruby and Sapphire, or whatever. An issue I had with Pokemon Black and White was that I felt that there were too many unappealing looking Pokemon. I mean, I know we've had strange looking Pokemon in Generation 1, such as Jinx, Mug, and Tangela, but I feel like the 5th generation had way too many. Up until now, I really like the designs of the new Generation 6 Pokemon, even the few stranger looking ones I have encountered, such as Swirlix. Unfortunately, I don't have internet in my house right now, so I can't play with any of my friends online, so I feel like I'm missing out on part of the fun. But anyway, thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, then please like and comment below. If you'd like to see more videos, then please subscribe to my channel. Links are down in the description bar. Finally, in case you guys are wondering, I'll show you my current team. If you like, feel free to tell me who your team is in a formal comment or even in a video response. So until next time, Panda-chan out. Peace!
Pokemon.